The Bangalore Metropolitan Transport Corporation is the biggest and the only profit-making urban public transport undertaking in the country today with no accumulated loss. Keeping pace with the fast and furious growth of Bangalore City, BMTC has travelled far since its formation in 1997 with an impressive track record and now leads by example in being the only bus corporation within the city of Bangalore to ferry more than 4.2 million commuters every day. The mission of the organization has been to provide safe, reliable, eco-friendly, efficient and affordable travel to everyone. And it has realized this mission to a large extent and lived up to the trust reposed in it by both the people and the government. Carving a niche for itself in the public life, BMTC over the years has helped turn the wheels of economic progress of Bangalore City and the state. Public transport is a vibrant sector and demand for this category of transportation is ever on the increase, particularly in a city like Bangalore, where there is no satisfactory, affordable and dignified alternative. Commuter comfort and satisfaction being one of the foremost concerns of BMTC, it is now the very much preferred mode of transportation in the choice of public. They find the service efficient and economical, reliable and reasonable, and also safe and punctual. To cater to the needs of commuters, BMTC runs a variety of bus services. Vajra services are premium services of BMTC, providing high comfort to the commuters. This service is operated by deploying Volvo-based buses that are air-conditioned, Euro 3 with kneeling mechanism. Vayu Vajra Airport Service is also a Volvo-based service, offering high-end air-conditioned comfort to passengers in an effort to wean them away from personalized modes of travel. The service is available round the clock, providing seamless connectivity between important areas of the city and Bangalore International Airport. The Big Ten services deploy buses on major corridors coming in from surrounding suburbs in the city. These buses are run on a direction-based concept. The Suvarna services are a fleet comprising air suspension and high comfort buses which are specially deployed during peak hours. Pushpak services are operated by deploying branded buses having added comfort features such as better upholstered seats with headrest and more leg space. These services are specially popular for chartered service and casual contract. Parisar Vahini buses have been designed to be eco-friendly, as the name Parisar, meaning environment, suggests. These buses operate in the city as well as suburban areas. BMTC also operates tailor-made services to suit specific requirements of the commuters like students, factory employees and corporate staff. Thus, with a variety of services, BMTC in a day operates 5,864 bus schedules, running 13 lakh service kilometers and making 79,445 trips. It carries more than 43 lakh passengers daily. The corporation comprises a fleet of over 6,122 buses, covering an area encompassed with a radius of 36 kilometers from the city center, providing to the public the most cost-effective mode of transport. The organization now earns around 3.4 crore rupees every day, and it has been going from strength to strength financially. Prior to August 15, 1997, the scenario of public transport system in Bangalore was quite different and on the other extreme. there were two divisions of Karnataka State Road Transport Corporation, the Bangalore Transport Service South and North. There was lack of managerial skills, poor operational efficiency levels and indiscipline. Morale among workers was low and strikes were called at the drop of a hat. In the year 1989, the number of strikes organized by the workers were 6. In the year 1990, the number of strikes went up to 26 and there were 49 strikes in the year 1993. The workers were in continuous confrontation with the management and militancy in labor unions was growing. The workers indulged in all kinds of protests, including indefinite hunger strikes. The outcome of this lawlessness was poor operational and financial performance. The BTS continuously incurred operational losses until 2002-2003, except in the year 2001-2002. The gross revenue generated was less than the cost incurred, resulting in net losses. The then government of Karnataka initiated measures to reform the transport system by bifurcating BTS divisions and establishing an independent corporation, the BMTC. BMTC now became an independent corporation, but it had all the problems that existed in the former BTS divisions. So there was an urgent need to create a new face of the corporation in the eyes of the public by bringing a change in its working system. After careful study and analysis, BMTC identified some lead factors which were pulling down the performance of the organization. Several reformatory measures were then adopted to transform itself into a professionally administered entity.
We basically identified a model that had institutions, actors, and ideas. So BMTC as such had a whole lot of institutions in it. We strengthened those institutions. And number two, identified actors, whether it's officers or mechanics or drivers or conductors. So we create an enabling atmosphere where everybody could contribute his best. So we looked first at the institutions, we looked at the actors, and of course, we also created a sort of accommodative place for new ideas.
The corporation began with improving its civil infrastructure, like bus stations and depots. It built major bus stations as well as minor bus stations in different parts of the city. As a result, there was reduction in the number of buses in depots and supervision became more effective, leading to operational efficiency. The average age of buses at the time of formation of BMTC was quite low. Old buses not only had high maintenance and fuel costs, but they also had higher rates of breakdown. The corporation replaced aged vehicles and also inducted new vehicles of Euro 1, Euro 2 and Euro 3 levels in the fleet gradually. The corporation also gave attention to improved vehicle condition through improved maintenance practices and subjecting vehicles to preventive maintenance processes. Efforts were made to attend to the vehicles regularly for their preventive maintenance. The central workshop was given an entirely new layout so as to minimize interdepartmental movement of men and material. In addition, the defects noticed by the crew during running of the buses were attended to on top priority. The expansion of services by the BMTC was a continuous process. New bus schedules were added and daily service kilometers were also increased to meet the need of daily commuters. Efforts were also made to streamline and monitor the operations.
We also changed the idea that don't operate at a static level of number of buses. You expand because people are increasing, there is a market. So you have to be aggressive in marketing your transport, this thing.
Expansion of services was a necessity. But the corporation at that time had no funds for induction of new vehicles. So it opted for the induction of private capital through hiring of private buses. A system of taking private buses on wet lease was introduced. The cost of operation of these buses was less than the cost of operation of BMTC buses. So the corporation saved significant revenue by adopting this scheme. The BMTC also offered services of mega, outer and inner ring road for faster transportation without touching central business district area. To bring a change in the travel pattern by creating better connectivity with higher frequency, the corporation introduced grid route services. These grid route services were direction oriented. Under this system, commuters were facilitated to reach their destination with one changeover. Rationalization of routes was taken up as a continuous regular program. Some of the low-paying trips were diverted to high-density routes. This resulted in better utilization of vehicles and also increased revenue of the corporation. A number of commuter-friendly initiatives were also taken. Bus timetable containing bus departure details of city, suburban and pushback services along with route maps was introduced. Inquiry counters were established at all major bus stations, providing the latest information such as destination details, arrival and departure timings, en route places and other civic facilities. This was a juncture when the cost of operations was increasing rapidly. So the corporation introduced a new scheme to address the problem, an innovative PAR system. Taking into consideration commuters' travelling pattern in the city, the corporation launched monthly pass system. These passes were travel anywhere passes issued on a month-to-month basis and were non-transferable.
Pass gives you flexibility. It makes you travel in any bus, anywhere, anytime, and that reduces overloading in some buses. People get diverted to. And for us, you get money in the beginning of the month and you can improve your wage and means position. It gives you additional income.
The scheme became popular as it is an easy way to travel with no problem of paying exact amount of fare or small change. In step with the times, BMTC also took a big leap in adoption of the information technology. Extensive use of information technology helped the corporation to bring down the cost on manpower to a great extent. With computerization of all the operations in the depots such as ticketing, stores, accounting, etc., the manpower deployment at depots and other places for day-to-day administration was minimized. BMTC has been the first public transport undertaking in the country to use the sophisticated online GPS-based vehicle tracking and monitoring technology. With this system, it was able to track and monitor buses of BMTC and BMTC hired vehicles. Based on GPS reports, irregularities like missing of trips, deviation of trips, skipping of bus stops, early and late departures and arrivals of vehicles is traced out at the depots. This helped improve the efficiency and punctuality of operations. Introduction of multi-function workers was yet another initiative taken up by the corporation as the cost control measure. The drivers were made to double up as a conductor in conductorless operations, and for mobile maintenance units, the mechanics were made to double up as drivers.
So we tied up, you know, what you call the micro level studies, and addressing of those problems helped us at a macro level.
Nothing endures but change. Innovative experiments by the BMTC turned into a success story. The corporation gradually reached a sound financial status after wiping out all its accumulated losses. Through committed leadership, the corporation was able to optimize its strengths, competencies, and efficiencies.
Since 1997 onwards, the mission of the BMTC has been to give a safe, comfortable, affordable, you know, public transport to the citizens of Bangalore. In the last 8 to 10 years, of course, there has been a steady growth in the organization. The workforce has multiplied. The fleet size has also multiplied. The turnover has really gone manifold. and the positive network has also been, you know, increasing year by year.
With the improved financial position, it was able to pay the dues to the workers promptly, and the motivation level of workers and the officers became very high. The improvement in the service levels was visible from its achievements in terms of reduced instances of cancellations in operations and continuous increase in effective kilometers operated. With the induction of new buses and with better maintenance practices, the rate of breakdown reduced from 0.55 per 10,000 kilometers in 97-98 to 0.4 in 2010. There was an improvement in the ratio of kilometer per liter as well. With preventive maintenance, the accidents caused due to mechanical failures were also reduced. This resulted in bringing down and minimizing the rate of accidents from 0.32 in 1997-98 to 0.12 in 2010. As on December 2010, 3,872 new bus schedules were added since 1998-99, and daily service kilometers have been increased from 0.4 million to 1.25 million kilometers. New vehicles were also added gradually, and the fleet strength went up to 6,122 vehicles in 2010. BMTC was in a financial mess at the time of its formation in 1997. It had financial deficit of 7.82 crore rupees in 1997-98. With concerted efforts at all levels and adopting cost-cutting measures, BMTC was able to maintain the cost of operation at the minimum possible. During the years starting from 2002-2003, the corporation recorded continuously increasing cumulative profit, and accumulated losses were wiped out right in the year 2002-2003. The number of passengers per day travelling by BMTC buses also increased from 24.5 lakhs in 1997-98 to 42.5 lakhs in 2009-2010. The corporation recorded significant profits year after year. Its net worth at present touches 964.49 crore rupees as compared to 31.99 crore rupees in the year 2000.
I would say the freedom that they have enjoyed from the government is another reason why they are doing well. Fixation of fare, fleet augmentation, recruitment of people, there is a lot of freedom in Bangalore Metropolitan Transport Corporation. They have their own systems, they have their own way of recruiting people, and government doesn't interfere in that. So the freedom that they have enjoyed over a period of time has also resulted in their being competitive.
The success of BMTC is due to its singular focus on commuter satisfaction, and it has consistently attempted to enhance the travel experience of commuters by making their journeys enjoyable, comfortable, as well as affordable. BMTC now holds the youngest fleet in the country with an average age of 4 years. It also has the distinction of being the first urban corporation to introduce Volvo low-floor buses for its operations with a view to provide comfort and safe travel to the commuters, and also to motivate those having personal vehicles to use public transport services.
Bangalore Metropolitan Transport Corporation has been the pioneer in adopting the latest technologies, particularly in the area of induction, maintenance and operation of buses. BMTC is the first urban transport corporation in the country to introduce world-class air-conditioned buses with kneeling mechanism, air suspension, LED boards, voice announcement system and GPS tracking system. Today, you can see the variety of buses on Bangalore roads looking into the needs of different sections of the society.
BMTC also introduced monthly pass system and rainbow facilities to the monthly pass commuters. Under the scheme, the pass commuters will get risk coverage of 1 lakh rupees in case of any casualty and up to 20,000 rupees medical assistance in case of injury. There are other attractive features also attached to the pass system, and with the result, monthly pass passengers increased from 1.5 lakhs to 2.5 lakhs. In addition to monthly pass system, daily and weekly passes have also been launched. The daily pass sales have increased from 60,000 to about 1.7 lakhs. Bus route operation details are available on the internet as well. By choosing the origin and destination of one's choice, one can get details like bus services operated, timings, and bus stops en route. Route maps are also available on the monitor and printouts of information can be taken. Yet another innovation is the electronic ticketing machine, which is the latest technique adopted in passenger ticketing. Handheld ETMs are replacing the manual system of ticket issue. Safety of commuters has been the prime concern of BMTC. For the safety of commuters, pneumatically operated doors have been introduced on city buses. Over 3,341 such buses are under operation in the city. Deserving a special mention are what are known as specials. There are special services like free bus services to the station, court special, pass holder special, hospital special, and other such buses showing BMTC's social concern and commitment.
BMTC provides special bus service to the weaker section of the society, including women. Today, one cannot imagine Bangalore without BMTC. It is the lifeline of Bangalore, without which the city will come to a standstill. The credit of this transport system goes to the government of Karnataka, BMTC, proactive management and its strategies.
With the rapid growth of Bangalore, the floating population has also increased. A large number of people arrive in the city or leave at night. For hundreds of Bangaloreans, the day stretches far into the night. Considering the requirements of late-night travellers, BMTC launched night services. The number of night schedules has gradually been increased over the years, providing services from Kempegowda bus station to different residential extensions in late night and early morning. Controlling pollution and keeping the environment clean is one aspect of BMTC's eco-care and concern. Eco-friendly, pollution-free service is the mantra of BMTC.
We also take care that on account of running of more than 6,000 buses, we don't become a source of pollutant to the society in which we all live. We have almost brought in alternate fuels. It could be ethanol or it could be biofuel. So work is almost complete on all these aspects. We are going to ensure that our emissions are far below the permissible limits. We ensure that every day the emission levels of our buses are being checked.
In the last 13 years, BMTC has come a long way. It has stabilized itself and has won laurels all round. It won Prime Minister Civil Service Excellence Award in year 2009 and UITP ITF Outstanding International Award for Innovation in Public Transport in the year 2010.
We have taken a lot of initiatives to create awareness among the general public of Bangalore to make use of the public transport, which is very safe, which is healthy, which is eco-friendly, and which is very affordable.
Facilities ki bahut achhi hai, convenience bahut acha hai. Sabse achhi baat the 24 hours iski availability hai. I think this is one of the safest and the convenient mode of transport. So cheers to BMTC.
For BMTC, the focal point is the commuter, around whom its mammoth, well-knit and well-planned operations revolve. And the motive driving it is to provide him with efficient and economical, reliable and reasonable, and safe and punctual services. Realizing this motive is a continuous endeavor. Various and numerous other steps taken by BMTC, which have gone a long way in making real its cherished motive of commuter comfort and satisfaction. Bangalore Metropolitan Transport Corporation is the biggest and the only profit-making urban public transport undertaking in the country today with no accumulated loss. Keeping pace with the fast and furious growth of Bangalore City, BMTC has travelled far since its formation in 1997 with an impressive track record and now leads by example in being the only bus corporation within the city of Bangalore to ferry more than 4.2 million commuters every day. The mission of the organization has been to provide safe, reliable, eco-friendly, efficient and affordable travel to everyone. And it has realized this mission to a large extent and lived up to the trust reposed in it by both the people and the government. Carving a niche for itself in the public life, BMTC over the years has helped turn the wheels of economic progress of Bangalore City and the state. Public transport is a vibrant sector and demand for this category of transportation is ever on the increase, particularly in a city like Bangalore where there is no satisfactory, affordable and dignified alternative. Commuter comfort and satisfaction being one of the foremost concerns of BMTC, it is now the very much preferred mode of transportation in the choice of public. They find the service efficient and economical, reliable and reasonable, and also safe and punctual. To cater to the needs of commuters, BMTC runs a variety of bus services. Vajra services are premium services of BMTC, providing high comfort to the commuters. This service is operated by deploying Volvo-based buses that are air-conditioned, Euro 3 with kneeling mechanism. Vayu Vajra Airport Service is also Volvo-based service, offering high-end air-conditioned comfort to passengers in an effort to wean them away from personalized modes of travel. The service is available round the clock, providing seamless connectivity between important areas of the city and Bangalore International Airport. The Big Ten services deploy buses on major corridors coming in from surrounding suburbs in the city. These buses are run on a direction-based concept. The Suvarna services are a fleet comprising air suspension and high-comfort buses which are specially deployed during peak hours. Pushpak services are operated by deploying branded buses having added comfort features such as better upholstered seats with headrest and more leg space. These services are specially popular for chartered service and casual contract. Parisar Vahini buses have been designed to be eco-friendly, as the name Parisar, meaning environment, suggests. These buses operate in the city as well as suburban areas. BMTC also operates tailor-made services to suit specific requirements of the commuters like students, factory employees and corporate staff. Thus, with a variety of services, BMTC in a day operates 5,864 bus schedules, running 13 lakh service kilometers and making 79,445 trips. It carries more than 43 lakh passengers daily. The corporation comprises a fleet of over 6,122 buses, covering an area encompassed with a radius of 36 kilometers from the city center, providing to the public the most cost-effective mode of transport. The organization now earns around 3.4 crore rupees every day, and it has been going from strength to strength financially. Prior to August 15, 1997, the scenario of public transport system in Bangalore was quite different and on the other extreme. There were two divisions of Karnataka State Road Transport Corporation, the Bangalore Transport Service South and North. There was lack of managerial skills, poor operational efficiency levels and indiscipline. Morale among workers was low and strikes were called at the drop of a hat. In the year 1989, the number of strikes organized by the workers were 6. In the year 1990, the number of strikes went up to 26, and there were 49 strikes in the year 1993. The workers were in continuous confrontation with the management, and militancy in labor unions was growing. The workers indulged in all kinds of protests, including indefinite hunger strikes. The outcome of this lawlessness was poor operational and financial performance. The BTS continuously incurred operational losses until 2002-2003, except in the year 2001-2002. The gross revenue generated was less than the cost incurred, resulting in net losses. The then government of Karnataka initiated measures to reform the transport system by bifurcating BTS divisions and establishing an independent corporation, the BMTC. BMTC now became an independent corporation, but it had all the problems that existed in the former BTS divisions. So there was an urgent need to create a new face of the corporation in the eyes of the public by bringing a change in its working system. After careful study and analysis, BMTC identified some lead factors which were pulling down the performance of the organization. Several reformatory measures were then adopted to transform itself into a professionally administered entity.
We basically identified a model that had institutions, actors, and ideas. So BMTC as such had a whole lot of institutions in it. We strengthened those institutions. And number two, identified actors, whether it's officers or mechanics or drivers or conductors. So we created an enabling atmosphere where everybody could contribute his best. So we looked first at the institutions, we looked at the actors, and of course, we also created a sort of accommodative place for new ideas.
The corporation began with improving its civil infrastructure, like bus stations and depots. It built major bus stations as well as minor bus stations in different parts of the city. As a result, there was reduction in the number of buses in depots and supervision became more effective, leading to operational efficiency. The average age of buses at the time of formation of BMTC was quite low. Old buses not only had high maintenance and fuel costs, but they also had higher rates of breakdown. The corporation replaced aged vehicles and also inducted new vehicles of Euro 1, Euro 2 and Euro 3 levels in the fleet gradually. The corporation also gave attention to improve vehicle condition through improved maintenance practices and subjecting vehicles to preventive maintenance processes. Efforts were made to attend to the vehicles regularly for their preventive maintenance. The central workshop was given an entirely new layout so as to minimize interdepartmental movement of men and material. In addition, the defects noticed by the crew during running of the buses were attended to on top priority. The expansion of services by the BMTC was a continuous process. New bus schedules were added and daily service kilometers were also increased to meet the need of daily commuters. Efforts were also made to streamline and monitor the operations.
We also changed the idea that don't operate at a static level of number of buses. You expand because people are increasing, there is a market. So you have to be aggressive in marketing your transport, this thing.
Expansion of services was a necessity, but the corporation at that time had no funds for induction of new vehicles. So it opted for the induction of private capital through hiring of private buses. A system of taking private buses on wet lease was introduced. The cost of operation of these buses was less than the cost of operation of BMTC buses. So the corporation saved significant revenue by adopting this scheme. The BMTC also offered services of mega, outer and inner ring road for faster transportation without touching central business district area. To bring a change in the travel pattern by creating better connectivity with higher frequency, the corporation introduced grid route services. These grid route services were direction oriented. Under this system, commuters were facilitated to reach their destination with one changeover. Rationalization of routes was taken up as a continuous regular program. Some of the low-paying trips were diverted to high-density routes. This resulted in better utilization of vehicles and also increased revenue of the corporation. A number of commuter-friendly initiatives were also taken. Bus timetable containing bus departure details of city, suburban and pushback services along with route maps was introduced. Inquiry counters were established at all major bus stations, providing the latest information such as destination details, arrival and departure timings, en route places, and other civic facilities. This was a juncture when the cost of operations was increasing rapidly. So the corporation introduced a new scheme to address the problem. An innovative PAR system. Taking into consideration commuters' travelling pattern in the city, the corporation launched monthly pass system. These passes were travel anywhere passes, issued on a month-to-month basis and were non-transferable.
Pass gives you flexibility. It makes you travel in any bus, anywhere, anytime, and that reduces overloading in some buses. People get diverted to. And for us, you get money in the beginning of the month. And you can improve your ways and means position. It gives you additional income.
The scheme became popular as it is an easy way to travel with no problem of paying exact amount of fare or small change. In step with the times, BMTC also took a big leap in adoption of the information technology. Extensive use of information technology helped the corporation to bring down the cost on manpower to a great extent. With computerization of all the operations in the depots, such as ticketing, stores, accounting, etc., the manpower deployment at depots and other places for day-to-day administration was minimized. BMTC has been the first public transport undertaking in the country to use the sophisticated online GPS-based vehicle tracking and monitoring technology. With this system, it was able to track and monitor buses of BMTC and BMTC hired vehicles. Based on GPS reports, irregularities like missing of trips, deviation of trips, skipping of bus stops, early and late departures and arrivals of vehicles is traced out at the depots. This helped improve the efficiency and punctuality of operations. Introduction of multi-function workers was yet another initiative taken up by the corporation as the cost control measure. The drivers were made to double up as a conductor in conductorless operations. And for mobile maintenance units, the mechanics were made to double up as drivers.
So we tied up, you know, what you call the micro-level studies and addressing of those problems helped us at a macro level.
Nothing endures but change. Innovative experiments by the BMTC turned into a success story. The corporation gradually reached a sound financial status after wiping out all its accumulated losses. Through committed leadership, the corporation was able to optimize its strengths, competencies, and efficiencies.
Since 1997 onwards, the mission of the BMTC has been to give a safe, comfortable, affordable, public transport to the citizens of Bangalore. In the last 8 to 10 years, of course, there has been a steady growth in the organization. The workforce has multiplied, the fleet size has also multiplied, the turnover has really gone manifold, and the positive network has also been increasing year by year.
With the improved financial position, it was able to pay the dues to the workers promptly, and the motivation level of workers and the officers became very high. The improvement in the service levels was visible from its achievements in terms of reduced instances of cancellations in operations and continuous increase in effective kilometers operated. With the induction of new buses and with better maintenance practices, the rate of breakdown reduced from 0.55 per 10,000 kilometers in 97-98 to 0.4 in 2010. There was an improvement in the ratio of kilometer per liter as well. With preventive maintenance, the accidents caused due to mechanical failures were also reduced. This resulted in bringing down and minimizing the rate of accidents from 0.32 in 1997-98 to 0.12 in 2010. As on December 2010, 3,872 new bus schedules were added since 1998-99, and daily service kilometers have been increased from 0.4 million to 1.25 million kilometers. New vehicles were also added gradually, and the fleet strength went up to 6,122 vehicles in 2010. BMTC was in a financial mess at the time of its formation in 1997. It had financial deficit of 7.82 crore rupees in 1997-98. With concerted efforts at all levels and adopting cost-cutting measures, BMTC was able to maintain the cost of operation at the minimum possible. During the years starting from 2002-2003, the corporation recorded continuously increasing cumulative profit, and accumulated losses were wiped out right in the year 2002-2003. The number of passengers per day travelling by BMTC buses also increased from 24.5 lakhs in 1997-98 to 42.5 lakhs in 2009-2010. The corporation recorded significant profits year after year. Its net worth at present touches 964.49 crore rupees as compared to 31.99 crore rupees in the year 2000.
I would say the freedom that they have enjoyed from the government is another reason why they are doing well. Fixation of fare, fleet augmentation, recruitment of people, there is a lot of freedom in Bangalore Metropolitan Transport Corporation. They have their own systems, they have their own way of recruiting people, and government doesn't interfere in that. So the freedom that they have enjoyed over a period of time has also resulted in their being competitive.
The success of BMTC is due to its singular focus on commuter satisfaction, and it has consistently attempted to enhance the travel experience of commuters by making their journeys enjoyable, comfortable, as well as affordable. BMTC now holds the youngest fleet in the country with an average age of 4 years. It also has the distinction of being the first urban corporation to introduce Volvo low-floor buses for its operations with a view to provide comfort and safe travel to the commuters, and also to motivate those having personal vehicles to use public transport services.
Bangalore Metropolitan Transport Corporation has been the pioneer in adopting the latest technologies, particularly in the area of induction, maintenance and operation of buses. BMTC is the first urban transport corporation in the country to introduce world-class air-conditioned buses with kneeling mechanism, air suspension, LED boards, voice announcement system and GPS tracking system. Today, you can see the variety of buses on Bangalore roads, looking into the needs of different sections of the society.
BMTC also introduced monthly pass system and rainbow facilities to the monthly pass commuters. Under the scheme, the pass commuters will get risk coverage of 1 lakh rupees in case of any casualty and up to 20,000 rupees medical assistance in case of injury. There are other attractive features also attached to the pass system, and with the result, monthly pass passengers increased from 1.5 lakhs to 2.5 lakhs. In addition to monthly pass system, daily and weekly passes have also been launched. The daily pass sales have increased from 60,000 to about 1.7 lakhs. Bus route operation details are available on the internet as well. By choosing the origin and destination of one's choice, one can get details like bus services operated, timings, and bus stops en route. Route maps are also available on the monitor and printouts of information can be taken. Yet another innovation is the electronic ticketing machine, which is the latest technique adopted in passenger ticketing. Handheld ETMs are replacing the manual system of ticket issue. Safety of commuters has been the prime concern of BMTC. For the safety of commuters, pneumatically operated doors have been introduced on city buses. Over 3,341 such buses are under operation in the city. Deserving a special mention are what are known as specials. There are special services like free bus services to the station, court special, pass holder special, hospital special, and other such buses showing BMTC's social concern and commitment.
BMTC provides special bus service to the weaker section of the society, including women. Today, one cannot imagine Bangalore without BMTC. It is the lifeline of Bangalore, without which the city will come to a standstill. The credit of this transport system goes to the government of Karnataka, BMTC, proactive management and its strategies.
With the rapid growth of Bangalore, the floating population has also increased. A large number of people arrive in the city or leave at night. For hundreds of Bangaloreans, the day stretches far into the night. Considering the requirements of late-night travelers, BMTC launched night services. The number of night schedules has gradually been increased over the years, providing services from Kempegowda bus station to different residential extensions in late night and early morning. Controlling pollution and keeping the environment clean is one aspect of BMTC's eco-care and concern. Eco-friendly, pollution-free service is the mantra of BMTC.
We also take care that on account of running of more than 6,000 buses, we don't become a source of pollutant to the society in which we all live. We have almost brought in alternate fuels. It could be ethanol or it could be biofuel. So work is almost complete on all these aspects. We are going to ensure that our emissions are far below the permissible limits. We ensure that every day the emission levels of our buses are being checked.
In the last 13 years, BMTC has come a long way. It has stabilized itself and has won laurels all round. It won Prime Minister Civil Service Excellence Award in year 2009. and UITP ITF Outstanding International Award for Innovation in Public Transport in the year 2010.
We have taken a lot of initiatives to create awareness among the general public of Bangalore to make use of the public transport, which is very safe, which is healthy, which is eco-friendly, and which is very affordable.
Facilities ki bahut achhi hai, convenience bahut achha hai. Sabse achhi baat the 24 hours iski availability hai. I think this is one of the safest and the convenient mode of transport. So cheers to BMTC.
For BMTC, the focal point is the commuter, around whom its mammoth, well-knit and well-planned operations revolve. And the motive driving it is to provide him with efficient and economical, reliable and reasonable, and safe and punctual services. Realizing this motive is a continuous endeavor. Various and numerous other steps taken by BMTC, which have gone a long way in making real its cherished motive of commuter comfort and satisfaction.